Jack lanterns ain't got shit on me. Not fun. Hopefully now, though, after the soreness subsides, I'll actually feel a little bit better. But I can't imagine doing that with no anesthesia. But he looks like he got it all. All the way to the root, man. So I haven't had a tooth pulled in a while, but it is what it is, you know. Anyway, I have been told by the doctor to take it easy today and to chill and to take my ibuprofen and my Tylenol, and then you know. Rest. Well, that's it. That part of the ruckation is over with. I'm not really that swollen up. It's just gauze in my mouth. Big old piece of gauze in there. Anyway, hopefully I'm gonna rest up today, do a bunch of grinding of meat and stuff, and then head back out to the woods in the next day or two. So here we go. Yeah, I took 3 ibuprofen and a Tylenol at the same time because that's what the doctor said to do. So, let's see how he likes deer meat. This is a give me an excuse to eat ice cream.
You hear me?
It likes deer meat. It's gone. Look, man. I don't think you realize how sharp your little claws are. Damn. Hey! Hey! Easy! Attention whore. Alright, you gotta get down now.
No. No.
No!
Just layers on layers.
Stacks on stacks.
On stacks. On stacks, baby. Oh, Lord.
Make me happy. Zach, that one's yours. All right. Well, y'all, here it is. I look like a who from Whoville. The tooth is out. Meat has been processed and put back in the freezer in an orderly fashion. And I am back going out to hunt a little bit more. I'm a little bit sad, to be honest with you, because I'm tagged out on bucks now, which is a great thing. It's awesome. I got a nice spike this year and a nice 7-point, so that's really cool. The part that I don't like, though, is my hunting season. Even though there's a lot of hunting left to do, I'm almost tagged out on deer now. So I can still get one deer in zone 7 at the property, because the zone limit there is 5 deer. So I can get one doe with any means. And then I'll still have a doe tag for any other zone. So, I mean, that's kind of cool, but, and also, it's still bear season until the 30th, so that's really cool, you know. So, there's still lots of hunting to do. I mean, you never know when a pig or a whatever will walk by, you know, but, or a bear or whatever. But there's a certain sadness with, tagging out on your bucks for the season. There's a great sense of accomplishment, and then also a sense of, I don't know, doneness, if that's what you want to call it. So, anyway, regardless of all that, I'm headed back out to the mountain to have fun. I think I'll probably hunt the property this afternoon, today, and then I'll go and maybe hunt the public land starting tomorrow. Gotta be in by Sunday for Thanksgiving at Miss Dorothy's house. And then it's back on to hunting, unless I fill 2 doe tags in 2 different zones between now and then. So, look at those teeth. Yeah! Folks, here we are again. So, I already got the fire started here at the cabin. Got some corn put out. And, I've eaten a little bit of lunch, so I'm about to go sit out there and just see what happens. Have a nice little hunt. Hopefully a big, fat, juicy doe will come through. And I will be all tagged out this year in this zone. Still have another deer tag, doe, specifically, for another zone, but not for this one. Yes, it's awesome being me. Mm-hmm. So, here we go. I think this is the maybe the earliest that I've ever actually been tagged out on bucks in my whole life, you know. It's kind of cool. Not really a big deal, I guess, but it kind of is to me, you know. Like I said, the pressure's off. It's been on for a while. The freezer's full. Now I'm just enjoying hunting and watching cameras and spending time out here with me and the Lord, you know. So anyway, I'm headed down. I'm gonna sit over the fire break this evening, see if anything comes in. There's one little bitty spike buck around here that's, I don't even think he's a spike yet. I think he's more of a button buck. Hold on a minute. Damn it. It's one of them stupid, you know, them numbers that call you that look like they're local, but then you answer it and it's not local. It's some scam. I hate those guys. Anyway, there's a little buck down here, and on the camera, his little horns are about that long, so he might actually be hard to tell if he's a buck or a doe. That's the definition of a button buck. When you scope them at 100 yards and you can't even tell what they are, looks like a doe. That's button buck. So, anywho, we got lots of buck activity. I got some fresh scrapes and stuff down there, which I thought was pretty fun, pretty cool. So maybe there'll be a few does that aren't locked down and walking around trying to get something to eat this evening. Big, fat, juicy doe. Come on, let's go. Thank you.
break stand. And, nothing yet. It's okay, though. It's a beautiful day. It's Wednesday. It's modern gun season in Arkansas during the rut. I've got a doe tag or two. It's a great day to be alive, Tanner. And I'm in the deer stand. This is awesome. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Amen. So, when I tell you that I'm totally ecstatic about that 7-point I got the other day, a 2.5-year-old buck, that a lot of people might say I should have let him walk, I really do mean that I'm excited about it. I try to never pass up on the first day what I'd be happy to have the last day. Now I'm sitting in a pretty good position. I'm just having fun hunting. I have a couple more deer tags, but I don't need to shoot anything, really. I have meat. I would like to give some more meat away this year to family and friends, but other than that, it's only halfway through November. The Lord just is absolutely rocking it, man. And I get to be a little part of it, so. This is awesome. I got a tooth pulled yesterday, and I'm out here hunting again today. That's pretty badass, if I do say so myself. And I do. So I'm waiting on, Big Llewellyn to step out. See if I can't put a big nanny doe on the ground, or a bobcat to walk by, or a coyote or anything. It'd be awesome. Just plain awesome.
Well, folks, there he is, little button buck.
So, I am officially tagged out now. That's it. So, I got him hung up, and he should be good to go. He's out there chilling. Got him all cleaned up. And, yeah, that's it. He was banged up, too, man. They've been fighting like crazy around here, so. What do you do? I had a huge hole in my mouth. Crazy. Anyway, Lord's good.
Morning, everybody. Isn't it a lovely morning? Well, I've got Mr. Buttonbuck hung up out there. And he's been hanging up overnight. So I'm going to go ahead and get him dressed out after breakfast here. After that, I got to put them all up in the fridge, in the freezer. I should have enough room. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, get him in there. And then what I might go do is go hunt some damnables. Because as we all know, damnables need to be hunted, by God. And we have a plethora of damnables on this property. Corn-eating sons of bitches. Probably just need to kill them all, oh baby, kill them all now, yeah. Yay. If I get him put up, I might do a little evening hunting. See how many squirrels I can kill, and then get them all bagged up and put in the freezer, and then maybe go to the public land tomorrow, see if I can't find a doe or a bear. Either one would be awesome. Although, at this point, if I get a bear, I'm not sure where I'm gonna put it. And that is it. Let's have breakfast. Oh, yes. Look at that hair. Anyway, so I've got that little button buck all put up. These here were from the last one, but I got them all put up. Got the liver for dog food for the teacher and heart for me. But I'm going to get a good freeze on that. And going to have me some suppers and just chill the rest of the evening. I don't think I'm going to go squirrel hunting today. It's been a long day of processing the deer and... Not bad, Tater. I'm planning on going to the woods tomorrow to the public land. See what I can see. Maybe a bear, maybe a doe, maybe a coyote. Never know. Hell, there might be a pig in there. Who knows? But that should be fun. So today's Thursday. That'll be Friday. Yeah. That should be fun. Let's go. I know what you're thinking. Is he a genius? I am, in fact, a motherfucking genius. Oh! Ho, ho, ho. Yeah. Just got myself a nice little shed teepee holder. Genius! That is awfully pretty. Sure enough. Pretty awesome. Morning, everybody. I know what you're thinking. Look at that lay. Ooh. I know, not really. It is Friday morning. Days is this now? Monday, dude. Day 7 of the rutcation. And I slept in. No, I don't feel bad about sleeping in. Okay, I kind of do. But I shouldn't, because sleeping in is good for you when your body needs to sleep. When it doesn't, trust me, it'll let you know. It will make you get up. So, I'm gonna get ready and eat some breakfast a little bit. Get my stuff and head out to the public land. And hopefully I'll see a doe or maybe a bear. I read something the other day that bears in Arkansas don't actually start hibernating until like January, or, you know, they come out in March or something like that. So I guess they only hibernate really through the coldest months, even though it's pretty cold in November so far, so that's pretty cool. I think Miss Jane's gonna come out here with me one day next week, and that'll be fun. So anyway, that's the plan. Go out to the public and see what I can see. Should be fun. Come on. Okay. I was just sitting here editing this video and realized that this next part that you're about to watch is it's a madman rambling to himself. It's a madman. It's a hermit, a gnome hermit, that's been away from his people for too long or something. Check this out, man. Well, I just realized a little bit ago after I eat my breakfast before I go to the woods, I have to go down to the tree stand where I shot that button buck the other day, and I have to grab my thermos and my tiny binoculars because I forgot them. Yep. Sure did. No, probably a little bit of coffee there in the woods. You know. Mm. Raviolis for brunch. Yay!
Look at me. Raviolis for brunch. Yay! Mm.
Mouth is still a little sore, but not too bad, I guess. So, the plan is to get down there in the woods, sneak through the woods. I might even see something sneak into my deer stand. You never know. And then, try to go get a bear or a big fat doe.
Oh, God. Seriously. The ramblings of a madman.
If I get a doe or a button buck, any antlerless deer, I'll be done deer-wise for the whole season. I'll have no more deer tags. That'd be pretty cool, though. If I get a bear, that would be awesome. I got to remember to pull its premolar or something like that out of its mouth and send it into the Game and Fish.
Okay. Okay, I know that sounds crazy, ripping the bear's tooth out and sending it to Game and Fish, but that is seriously what you're supposed to do. I forget why. I don't know if it ages the bear or what, but you're supposed to cut out its premolar up here. And send that envelope to the Game and Fish Commission in Arkansas. But if you were just to say that to somebody, I gotta rip out this bear's tooth and send it to the Game and Fish. That does sound a little nutty. Also, this whole diatribe I've been having, looks like I'm talking to somebody on the side, but there's nobody over there. There's nobody over there.
Nice. Shouldn't be a problem. Anyway, that's a plan. I gotta go down real quick while I'm doing that. Getting that stuff out of the stand, I gotta put some cards back in some cameras. And then that's it. That's it, baby. Yeah. Ugh. Nice. All right, here we go.
Well, folks, I'm here in the mountains, and I'm probably a mile or two from my destination. Ooh, there's a lot more water down here now. That's good. Last time I was up here, I figured out that there was a back way to come into that clear cut in that that ridge. And so I used it. Whether I go from there or whether I go from the main trail, it's still about a half a mile back in there. And today, the wind is blowing pretty much straight from the north to the south. Which, if I go in there from the main trail, my wind will be blowing directly towards my stand. However, I think that might be the way to go. Because if I go through the back way, I'll have to be going through all that bedding and stuff, kicking stuff up. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing. But I think what I want to do is park on the main trail and then go in straight up the ridge, over the flat, over the creek, and go pretty much as straight in line with my my stand as possible, and then climb up in my stand. I'm gonna hunt all the way there though, because I got a half a mile ish, you know, seems like anyway, to go before I get there. So I'm gonna kind of still hunt my way in there. If I see something, great. It's got to be a doe or a button buck or a bear. If it's a buck, I gotta let it walk. Hopefully there's not too many hunters up here. I haven't seen anybody yet. Hopefully we can get a nice, big, fat, juicy doe on the ground. Or a bear. So, let's go.
I don't know if you can see that in front of me, but there's a trail right there. Straight ahead of me. I haven't seen anything move yet. Quiet. It's pretty open right now too. So anyway, I'm just gonna keep going straight up, I think, until I hit that old clear cut up there, and then hop up in the stand and see what I can see for the rest of the afternoon. Come on. That way to walk through that stuff. Anyway, I just spooked a deer down there. Don't know what it was, but I heard hooves hitting the ground, so you know, probably a deer. Anyway, I've got to get over to my spot now and get set up before I spook too much of anything else. Let's go. Okay. So I was just scanning my surroundings, showing y'all what I'm looking at, and I could have sworn I saw a deer over there just staring right at me about 100 yards, and I scoped it, and it is not a deer. It's just a brown patch of brush, but it looks just like a deer head and ears looking at me, I swear. Spot to hunt in. know for a fact it's not. So, I could be wrong on both accounts. I know I'm wrong on at least one. I still think this is a good setup for bow. For bow hunting. And my camera card was there this time, so the camera card thief did not take my camera card this time, which is a bonus. And I even brought my camera card reader picture thingy for my phone, so I'm gonna go through there real quick and see if I see anything cool on there. Dude, I wish y'all could see this. It looks just like a damn deer. That's amazing. Anyway, I'm here, and should be a good day, Tater. Let's go. Oh, I did bust a deer on the way in here. I never saw it, but I busted it. Hopefully that won't affect me seeing another one. It's kind of crispy through here too, so that's good. Maybe I'll hear one before it shows up. Alright, bye. Well, y'all. Feels like it's getting colder up here on the mountain. Beautiful, though. I had to stand up. This one has obviously been grown up for a while because it is thick. I don't know if that was a buck or doe a while ago, but whatever it was busting brush. Which makes me think it was a buck, but not necessarily. When an animal's running through this thick stuff, it doesn't matter if they have horns on their head or not. It's just really thick stuff, so. I keep thinking Big Llewellyn's gonna pop out behind me while I'm having my cup of joe. Because that would be perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So that makes like the third time I've come up here. And I've done it three different routes so far. That's a good thing, I don't know. God, it's getting cold. I am convinced that if a person can kill a public land deer, buck or doe, every year, that person is an awesome hunter. Shot at one last year and I chose not to take it, but I could have had one. Hopefully I'll get a doe this year on public land. That would be awesome. Alright, coffee break's over. There's something in the bushes in front of me. I've been listening to it now for a while. I still can't see it. Whatever it is, it's almost directly downwind of me. Pretty close. Whatever it is. Now it might be a squirrel, I have no idea. I don't think it's gotten my wind. just gonna continue to listen. Well, y'all, I don't know what that was, but it's 3 o'clock and I'm having a snack. Y'all, I've gotten down out of my tree, and I'm gonna steal my way back to a warm truck. It's freaking cold out here, which means the deer should be moving, but I don't think they're moving right here right now, so just gonna go right up over the ridge, probably down west a little bit, and then down onto that oak flat. Just kind of see what I can see. Maybe the wind's not quite as bad over there. Let's go. Out of the wind a little bit. There's not a lot of sign in here, but it's not a bad place to catch one walking through. The top of the ridge is about 100 yards behind me. Thinking about just sitting here until it gets dark, you know. Maybe I'll catch one kind of walking down through here or something. Who knows? I'm right on the edge of a transition from that high cut, that clear cut up on the mountain, down to a creek bottom down here. There's quite a few oaks still. I don't know that there's any acorns left, but there's quite a few oaks. Looks like there's some browse down here for them to eat too, so we'll see. We'll see. Well, it's about 4:55, I think. Up in this spot right here, just waiting. I really do hope I see a doe or a bear. If I get one more deer, I will be tagged out like for the first time ever in Arkansas. really stressed about it though. I mean, that's a cool goal to have, but I'm not really stressed out about it. Right now, I'm just having fun sitting in the woods. Just me and the Lord. That's pretty fun. I imagine if any deer are gonna come out, it's gonna be pretty soon. I've got about an hour and a half or so of daylight left. So I'm just gonna chill and drink my coffee and see if we don't get lucky.
Well, got the fire going. I had my supper. I stopped by Sonic on the way back to the cabin, so it's over here getting my backside warm. It's been a pretty good day, Tater. Not a bad day at all. At all. See if we can't get some squirrels tomorrow. See you then.